Hello and welcome to the Devlog number 4 of Planetary Life, a simulation game about planets, life and evolution. This time we are going to talk about creatures' evolution. For this update I had to make multiple changes to the lifeform system. Now the creatures, apart from a life bar, also have an energy bar, which defines how much energy the creature has left before it starts to starve and subsequently die. In order to survive, lifeforms must prevent their energy bar from reaching zero. On the other hand, an aging bar has also been added. Creatures will have three different ages: infancy, adulthood, and old age. When they are infants, they will not be able to reproduce, and their size will be smaller. If we wait long enough, we will see how the creature passes to the adult phase and grows in size. During the adult phase, the creature can begin to reproduce. And finally, in the last phase, old age, when it reaches its maximum size limit, the creature will die. New properties has also been added: energy consumed per turn, total energy, life, strength on land, attack, speed in the water, defense, speed in the air, range of vision, minimum support temperature and maximum support temperature. And on the other hand, traits has been added: unique abilities that the creature can have, such as the type of food they can consume, the type of reproduction they use, or if they can swim or fly, and many other things that you will discover. Of course, the components we select in the evolution menu will affect all these properties. Another change that has been made is that evolution must now be done step by step. We cannot go from a snake to a body with 10 legs in one step. Apart from the already known components like legs, eyes, tail and so on, three new types of components has been added: digestion, reproduction and skin. The digestion components will define what the creatures can eat and the level of energy they can accumulate. Currently, we can create creatures that eat plants, vegetarians, eat meat, carnivore, or combine both components and create an omnivore. Also, as we evolve the digestive system components, we will be able to store more energy to improve survival. Lifeforms will start with a type of reproduction by mitosis, which will simply make a copy of themselves. This reproduction system can evolve into viviparous or eventually oviparous. The selected reproductive system will influence how creatures reproduce in the environment and the chances of survival of pairs. A very important component is the skin. This component will allow us to move from a simple lifeform to a more advanced one with body, limbs, and other components. Not only does it allow us to continue to advance in the evolution of our lifeforms, it also allows us to improve survival in more difficult environments. For example, here we have a creature that we are going to move to one of the poles of the planet, where the temperature is quite cold. After moving it, we see that it suffers from cold and lost life. It will die soon. We are going to evolve its skin to better withstand such low temperatures. By evolving the basic skin component it already had, we are offered 4 options: skin with feathers, with scales, with fur, and osteoderms skin. Each skin offers different properties and temperature resistance. For this case, we will use the skin with fur, which withstands very low temperatures. After evolving the creature and applying the changes in the skin, we can see that it now withstands cold well. Finally, the game offers automatic mutations that will happen randomly each time a creature reproduces. These evolutions will be random and can benefit or negatively affect the creature. If we enjoy watching an ecosystem evolving without intervening, we can sit back and watch life and natural selection do its work. This update has been one of the biggest because I had to rebuild many parts of the game related to the creatures. On the other hand, as some of you may have noticed, many other changes have been made, which I will discuss in future videos. So far, I hope you have enjoyed all these new changes, and I hope to see you again soon. See you!
Planetary life, everything is struggle and strife. However, in the midst of all the pain,
there's always something that remains. Whether it's creatures, plants, or stars in space, they all continue to exist in their own time and place. While some may perish, others will take their place. For in the end, nothing stays the same. There's a beauty in the way that life changes, even if it's something that's hard to see. The planets continue to turn, and life goes on endlessly.